Today we're going to show you our Secotom-60 benchtop precision cutting machine. The 60 is the top of the range machine, which allows you to use automatic accessories like the X table. It comes with a laser to allow you to accurately line up cuts, and it will take our full range of cutting wheels up to 200mm in diameter. Today we're going to be cutting some coated cast iron. We're going to be using the 50A20 cutoff wheel, and we're going to be using the vertical clamp to keep the sample in position. Other clamps are available and can be found in the brochure. Matt's now going to secure the workpiece and set it up in proximity to the wheel. We're going to position the sample so that the coating is what we're going to cut through first. Now the sample's secure, Matt's now going to close the lid and we'll set the parameters. The parameters on the machine start with a cutting wheel, which Matt's going to select, which is the 50A20. All of our cutting wheels are pre-programmed into this machine. We're now going to select the RPM, which has been pre-selected for us, although you can adjust this if needed. Matt's now onto the feed speed, so this is how quickly the sample is going to be cut. Because it's quite hard, we're going to start quite gentle at 0.05 mm/s. The machine can run from 0.005 up to 3 mm/s. We're now onto the cut length, so this is the distance that the table is going to travel back through the wheel. We've pre-measured this sample, so we're going to put it at about 40 mm, which should give us enough clearance to completely cut the sample. The next setting is the return position. So you've got three options here. You've got stay, zero, and start. We're going to use start. This means that the table will return to its original position, allowing us easy access to the workpiece once it's finished cutting. Next is the cutting mode. So on this machine, you've got direct cut or you've got exicut. Today we're going to use the exicut, which is like a pulsing motion, which allows us to get a bit more coolant between the wheel and the sample. Because the sample is quite hard, we want to keep it as cool as possible to get the best possible finish. Now everything's in place, Matt's going to set the machine running. Once the wheel's up to speed, the machine will then start cutting the length that's been preset. As you can see, once the machine's cutting, you do get a separate cutting menu. On that at the top, you've got the feed speed, which can be adjusted during the cut, and we will adjust it once we've got through the hardened coating on the sample. You've got the RPM, and you've got the cut length, which can also be adjusted during the cut if you don't think you've given yourself enough length to cut through the material, or alternatively, if you've over-egged it and you want to cut it back. In the bottom left-hand corner, you'll see a timer, which will give you the time that it's going to take to do the cut. As you can see, this is going to be roughly around 12 and a half minutes from now. The bottom section, which is green, is indicating the load on the motor. This works like a traffic light system. Obviously green, going to amber, then going to red. If you've asked the machine to work what it thinks is too hard, so the load of the motor is up around the amber or even into the red, the machine will try and back itself off so it doesn't burn the sample or burn out the motor, and if it can't do that, it will stop and ask you to reset the parameters. This is a safety feature to protect both the machine and the sample that you're trying to cut. As you can see in the bottom right of the picture, that's the dead man's switch, so when the lid is up on the machine, that button has to be compressed so that you can move the table in any direction or adjust the height of the wheel. That's one of the latest safety features in the new Secotom-60 range. The noise that you can hear now is obviously the pulsating of the table, allowing the extra coolant in there, so it's like an axe chopping rather than a wheel cutting. Now we're through the hardened section, Matt's just going to speed up the cut. set it to 0.1 millimetres per second, and as you can see, that's drastically reduced the time of the cut. As you can see, the blade is nicely getting through the workpiece. The load on the motor is still pretty low, so we're okay at the speed that we've decided to cut at. So it looks like the 40mm that I've set might be a bit tight, so I'm actually just going to extend the cut by a couple more millimetres just to make sure that we get fully through the sample. Matt's just speeding up the cut there just to bring it to a finish. Now the cut's finished, the table will now move back to the start position as previously programmed. Once the wheel stops, there'll be a couple of seconds delay, and then you'll hear the beeps of the interlock releasing. There we go. Right, safe to enter and take the sample out. As you can see, it's a nice clean cut, ready to be dried off and move on to the next step.